Guys, antlers aren't the main reason we go hunting, but at the same time, I don't know anybody who doesn't like shooting a big buck. And, you know, food plots, mineral sites, feed stations, all those things that we do, nothing has as big of an impact as letting deer get a little bit older. And that's, you know, that's something anybody can do, Mark. And the difficulty, though, comes in, how do I know how old that deer is?
Right.
You know, our purpose here today is to give you a couple quick tips on how to make that decision when you don't have a lot of time to study the deer, mm-hmm. right?
Right.
So, first of all is look at the body. If you look at the face, the neck, the shoulders, and the stomach, there's a really nice jump between ages 2.5 and 3.5. And again, you know, if you watch a couple videos, a 2.5-year-old buck looks like a big doe. It's kind of lean, kind of long. Mm-hmm. Whereas that 3-year-old's starting to get a little bit of muscle. It's got a little, you know, the neck starts to swell a little bit. So that's the first thing that I look at. You also want to look at the antlers too, because, you know, it's hard not to. You know, your eyes kind of get glued to that. So there's a couple things that I look at. First is mass. Now take this Pennsylvania 8-pointer I shot about 20 some years ago. I'm showing my age here, but this deer was probably a 2.5-year-old. And I say that because of the mass. Look how thin these antlers are. Now at the time, this was the biggest deer I'd ever seen in the woods.
Sure.
And I was really happy with this deer, and I still am happy with this deer. But, you know, looking back, it's like, wow, that deer could have been something in another year or so. Now, this is a 10-pointer that I shot in Illinois with my bow a couple years ago. This deer is not an old deer either, but it's got a little bit more mass. So this deer could have been a 3-year-old, mm-hmm. but again, it's one that I made a split decision on, and I don't have any regrets about it. It's a decent deer. If you're after a deer that's a certain score, let's say you're with an outfitter or something, you know, you have to meet a minimum score. First of all, try to determine that it's at least a 3.5-year-old. An outfitter's not going to be happy. If you shoot a nice 2.5-year-old, he's not going to be real thrilled. So once you've determined, okay, look, this is a decent mature deer, mm-hmm. and you have to determine, does it meet the minimum antler score? Here's a real quick guide, guys. An average 8-pointer with no deficiencies is going to score in the low to mid 120s.
Okay.
All right. This deer, as an 8-pointer, has some deficiencies, being one, very very thin mass, mm-hmm. not a lot of mass. Mm-hmm. Brow tines are really kind of short too. So this deer might not even make 120.
Right.
If you're with an outfitter, this is not the deer that you want to shoot. Now this deer as a 10-pointer is going to make the minimum. But at the same time, it's not going to score real high because his deficiencies are not real good tine length. I mean, he's got, you know, 5 inches here, maybe 6 inches here.
And his G2s are even shorter than
right,
his 3s.
Exactly. So this deer is probably going to be about a 130-inch deer. So he is going to make the minimum, mm-hmm. but he's not that giant 10-pointer that you're looking for,
right.
probably. Now, there are some deer that you don't even have to think about.
Like that?
I got this deer in Saskatchewan a couple years ago, and now, again, this deer does not score real high, but I could tell instantly that it was a mature old buck. The mass is just incredible if you look in through here. So when you see mass like this, you know that that's probably a mature deer. Mm-hmm. Now, again, you can't judge a deer's age by its antlers, but there are certain characteristics that really indicate a lot of age, and mass like that is kind of the key that I look for.
Right.
So those are just a couple tips on, you know, how to quickly judge a deer. First, look at the body. Is he at least 3.5? That's the one thing you look for. Next, look at the antlers. So again, an average 8-pointer with nothing deficient is going to be in the mid to low 120s. An average 10-pointer with no deficiencies is going to be in the mid 130s.
Right.
Another key, guys, trail camera photos. If you can look at a photo ahead of time before you go to a stand and know this deer's been seen from this stand, he is a shooter, he's not a shooter. It's a really good feeling when a buck walks out and you can go, oh, okay, I know exactly what deer that is, I'm gonna let him go, or, oh, I need to shoot that deer. So again, there's a couple real quick ways to kind of field judge a deer and make that decision. Watch some videos, get trail camera photos if you can, and best of all, just have fun, take the deer that makes you happy, and don't worry about what anybody else thinks.